Okay.
Can you do some deep breathing?
No, you do that on your own.
No, no, you're good.
Okay, I'm here for you.
No, no, close your eyes and we're gonna center it.
Okay, just get there.
One more. Hi guys, welcome back. So today Joe and I are here together to do this lovely video. We had Joe on our channel.
This is part two.
Part two. Outfits, better glam,
yeah.
Better skincare, amazing. Less makeup.
That's the thing.
We're here, baby. Basically, I asked you guys on Instagram, so be sure to follow me on Instagram. Maybe in the future Joe will post some dating advice on his Instagram, so feel free to follow him there. We asked basically what questions that you wanted to hear in terms of dating advice or questions you wanted to ask guys but were afraid to ask. And then Joe was courageous and brave and is doing God's work, really.
I wouldn't say that, but I was just being honest, just being myself, just one man's opinion, one man's take.
Doing God's work. What are the signs of a guy liking you? It's so frustrating.
I mean, this goes both ways and it's a tale as old as time. I mean, like, I think it's kind of clear if someone's into you or not. Like, if they're excited to talk to you or, like, the way they text you and, like, want to see you and you're, like, you know, messaging.
Reciprocity.
Messaging to, like, set up the next date. Like, to me, like, when a girl is, like, takes forever to respond to your text and gives very kind of, like, curt, like, short answers that are, like, that's a bad sign. That's what I think.
Yeah.
And so, like, if you like someone, I think, like, you're gonna make sure you sound enthused when you're texting with them and, like, you're gonna wanna plan the next date. It must be nice to be a pretty girl everywhere you go. Oh, everyone's being so nice and friendly to me. All these guys are saying hello, asking me how I'm doing. I don't even know them and they're interested in how my day is.
Do you guys stalk the girl they like on Instagram? Like, they watch who follows them and who they follow?
I've never gone that far to care who follows them and who they follow. But, like, I think whenever I like a girl and she's on Instagram, I'll look at all of her photos and stuff. I think everyone does
that. Show support.
You know, you don't want to, like a photo from 7 months ago, but, you know, you're gonna look at her photos and watch her story.
I think girls do that. If I like a guy...
Well, no. Girls are known for being, like, social media, like, stalkers. Little FBI agents.
I'll find everything.
Yeah.
I'll have to care, so it'll take me a little bit, but once I care, I just do a little, all right, how many people we add in? Let me see you know, you want to be well researched, right? Whenever you make any sort of decision, financial, relationship, you want to be educated. It's trigger for guys on a first date.
Being egregiously late.
Oh, you talked about that before.
I did. I think it's the number one worst thing. And like I said, if you're running 10 or 15 minutes late and you give a heads up, like, even that sucks, but it's like, okay, at least you gave give enough heads up.
Because it's disrespecting your time.
Yeah, but if you show up 30, 40 minutes late, like, that is...
People show up 40 minutes late.
Girls do that all the time.
I would leave. You should leave.
And sometimes a girl isn't even that apologetic about it. And
would you leave?
40 minutes is the absolute cutoff. Yeah.
You would wait 40 minutes.
Well, if she's texting, like, I'm on the way, like, in the, you know, if there's, like, an ongoing communication.
You just show them who's boss. You say, no, baby. Sorry.
I know you can take it. I know it's my joking, my banter. You can take it.
What if I can't take it? I just pretend like I take it and then I cry about how it was really rough. Your opinion on one night stands and how it affects energy for men and women. You said so you can have a one night stand, doesn't mean anything to you?
I think, yeah, I mean, I think typically, like, a man can just have sex with a random person and it doesn't have to mean anything. Or
is that weird for you though? Like, you're literally, like, you know, with a random, like, you don't know them, you don't know their life.
Well, look, it usually happens because there was, like, drinking involved, obviously, and... But I mean, I think it doesn't always have to be like a weird, awkward, bad thing. Like, two people could really be into each other, you know, just meet that night and go home together, and it doesn't have to be a weird, awkward thing, you know?
Is it weird the next day? I've never been involved
only,
in
only if you want to make it weird.
Like, hang out with them?
Well, sometimes you wake up, like, I'm sure many men have had a one night stand because they were so drunk and they wake up and they're like, whoa, like, this is not what I wanted to do and I'm not that into this person. And then you don't want to go out and get breakfast or anything like that.
Has that happened to you?
Yeah, it has happened to me, yes.
You don't like the person the next day?
Well, you're just like, you know, this is okay. I was wasted last night. It's time to get a move on.
I have a question for you, kind of piggybacking off this question. What would you say what is the reason that most relationships or dating come to an end, that you've seen a pattern, maybe in yourself or other friends? Like, let's say people are dating on apps, dating, 2, 3, 4, whatever, how many dates. Why does it not go the step further, right? Because clearly people aren't dating apps for months, years, whatever, because it's not getting elevated to the next step. Assuming you want a relationship again.
Well, I think the number one reason is people maybe think they want a relationship, but then they realize they don't. And also dating apps and all, like having all these options available to you can become like an addiction. And so it's like when the other person clearly wants a commitment and you to just be with them, but you're not totally there and you have all these other options, that's, you know, that's a typical reason, I think.
Yeah, there's a lot of psychology articles that discuss like what dating apps do to your mind. It makes you feel like there's always like the grass is greener, but really it's another person with their own issues and their whole life.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, yeah. Our parents couldn't just load up their, you know, dating app on their phone and be like, oh, there's 30 people in my area that I could go on a date with tonight, potentially, or love.
Oh, when should a girl express the commitment thing, do you think, is appropriate? When would you find appropriate for a girl to be like, hey, like, where is this going? Because I no one wants to have their time wasted, and for girls, their prime is their youth.
I think after you've gone on 4 dates, like, if you're still on, if, like, that's a reasonable time to be like, okay, so, like, if we're going to keep seeing each other, is it because this is going to turn into something? You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's a reasonable answer. Your time is precious. Best tips for accepting or overcoming a recent breakup, even if it was with someone you were in an official relationship with. This is what is the most common these days. It's like the situationship, if you will. It's what the kids on the call.
I mean, I think it's the cliched answer of just like focus your energy on yourself and like doing productive stuff. Like whether it's your work or working out or just like, don't like let your happiness be constantly dictated by other people that you're not even seriously dating.
And then I think that it's even more important to take precaution, like even if you're dating someone, to remember like, it's hard not to have expectations of people because like, it's human nature, but I try not to be attached. Like, you don't know this.
Like you don't want to be emotionally closed off, but also like don't let other people be the one that have the power over you to always dictate your happiness.
Cause like, yeah, their actions aren't a reflection of you, their actions are a reflection of them. At the end of the day,
that's true. It's deep.
Yeah,
that's deep.
At what age do you guys think about settling down? Yeah, Joe, tell us. At what age?
That is different for all guys, for all people. I mean, I from all my friends from growing up in high school.
When did they get married? Around what age? Do you remember?
All like between 28 and 32, for the most part.
Yeah, that makes it
pretty much everyone. Sense. Everyone I grew up with is married, and most of them have kids. But I think it's also different if you live in a city like New York or LA. It's just a different kind of lifestyle. And I think most guys in those, like, I don't know. It depends on where you live and the context and situation.
What are some questions guys ask on a date and why do they ask those questions? Yeah, like, I guess.
What do you mean? The guy's gonna ask, anyone's on a first date's gonna ask questions.
If you're interested in someone, what do you, like, if you wanna see this person, okay, I have a good one.
Let's hear
it. If you were to ask 3 questions of someone to see, like, if you only could ask them 3 questions before you had to choose if you would date them or not, like, you had to make a decision, what 3 questions would you ask?
I always think a good question is learning about what their, like, family life is like and their relationship with their parents, because I think that can say a lot about a person.
Mm-hmm.
I would say, what's another question? I don't know.
If you had, like, you go on a date, you only have 3 questions and you have to decide. It's like
to ask 3 questions.
Yeah, and you decide. You have to decide you're going to date them or not. This is, like, again, like another date.
You could. I think the political question could be good.
Yeah.
Like, whether they're liberal or conservative.
You'll save time, for sure.
You'll save time. And also just to understand their mindset and the way they think about things.
It translates, for sure.
And then I would say, like, what, I think it's okay to ask, even on a first date, like, what they're looking for. Like, what's dating like for them at that time?
Mm-hmm.
And if they're like, yeah, you know, I've been on dating apps, going on a lot of dates, then you kind of get an idea. Or if they're like, you know, I'm really looking for a serious relationship,
mm-hmm.
That's good to know too.
Yeah, those are really good.
That's what I would say.
And we're gonna finish off with one dating tip that you could give girls that you feel like will make the biggest impact. Like, something of such value and such that you could sprinkle for us that you think will make powerful change.
I would say it's good to go into like a first date thinking like there's a reason why this person wants to go out with me and it could actually become something. Like if you're just like very like flippant and casual or like, I think you need to like just go into it like with a very, very positive attitude, I would say. Because a guy can tell if the girl is like just kind of like eh about it. You know what I mean? And that like ruins the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
But like if you just like, there's a, like, so you're
only,
going there, could, there's obviously the
so
guy
wants. If you're really interested, basically.
Yeah, and like assume that like, there's a reason why we're both taking the time to go on this date. You know what I mean? So like make the most of it and go into it thinking it can become something. I'm curious to see how people's comments to this one.
Yeah, me too.
Part 1 and the sequel.
And the sequel.
Bigger and better.
bigger and better always. 2020, we're starting it with a bang. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do you have any comments to say to... Everyone knows you as just like Joe. It's just funny. They're like, Joe.
That's who I am.
Yeah, just like three letters.
You be careful, kids. Have fun out there dating.
I would say my tips, put yourself first. You're like, don't be too nice. Care about yourself first. Obviously be kind, but like make sure you don't put yourself in compromising situations and be honest.
Yeah, and like you said, put yourself out there. Like, don't be scared. Maybe send that risky text or make that first move, you know?
Yeah, ask them.
You only have once. 2020, start of a new decade.
Ask them the three goals for that week.
Yeah, ask them the top five list.
Exactly, you know? Top five goals 2020.
Just don't, you know, just be cool.
Be cool. That's a tip. It's true. Yeah, the more chill you are, easygoing, the better. I honestly think that if something's meant to work out, it will find its way.
The universe will lead you to each other.
Even after we didn't, like, I didn't talk to Joe for a long time, and I ran into him at the mall.
Yeah.
It was wild. Yeah.
And like you said, it was like the universe putting us there together. Mm. She's so LA. I love it.
Okay, thank you guys so much for watching.
Thank you guys, this was fun.
We had a good time recording this. Please leave your feedback, leave your dating experiences down below. Let us know what your thoughts are. I'd love to start a conversation in the comment section or on Instagram or anywhere else. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you resonated with our message, with our chat, feel free to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.